What you think of Bernie Madoff, Lance Armstrong, or Elizabeth Holmes, or the war in Ukraine, it's clear that deception can have great consequences. And of course, detecting deception is clearly beneficial. But oddly enough, people are very poor lie detectors. When we give a number of statements, some lie and some truthful, to a number of people, and we assess their accuracy, what we typically see is that they don't perform above chance level. So on average, people perform at 54% accuracy, which is really, really bad. There's many experts out there from different fields, from psychology and law and economy and communication science, and they all have proposed different cues to deception, signs of deception or features of deception. But there's so many different signs of deception and little agreement on which signs are the best. And so the typical approach of deception experts is to select a number of these cues and try to combine them and weigh them into a final judgment. And different researchers and different tests or techniques, they differ in the number of cues that are used and how to weigh them and combine them. This standard approach has a number of problems. Perhaps most importantly, that most cues to deception are actually very weak. And there's actually only very few, perhaps only one good indicator of deception, and that's detailedness. So what we think is it might be beneficial to just focus on one good cue, the detailedness of a message. Because indeed, truth tellers have the details. They can tell these details from their memory and they can provide a more rich story, whereas liars don't have those details. And making up details actually also increases the risk of being exposed. We conducted a series of studies and we report 9 studies in our paper. And in all of these studies, we had people lying or telling the truth. So people in a truthful condition, they just described what they did in the last 30 minutes at the university campus. Maybe they had a coffee, maybe they talked with a friend, and maybe they went to the library. And that's a story they truthfully tell. But we also had students who were deceptive. So while they also tell that they had coffee or went to the library or talked to their friends, they actually did a staged crime. So they actually stolen an exam during that time and then didn't have coffee or went to the library or talked to their friends. And what we found is that, consistent with the literature, is that people are very poor at telling which stories are truthful and which are deceptive. Again, people typically perform at chance level. They cannot separate lie from truth. But when they used the best heuristic and only relied on the detailedness of the message, so when they only focused on how detailed is the story, they did better than chance level and better than the control condition. So that's an interesting find. And our approach might provide a new benchmark for deception research and also provide some guidance for people in their daily life, perhaps, how to judge the truthfulness of a message.